And I don't know what I did, but I stopped my music. That's weird. So I'm going to go ahead and start my music again. There we go. And we're going to get started. Soles of our feet together, knees out wide. Starting to move down on our backs. Again, allowing our knees to fall open with gravity. Allowing our shoulders to fall open with gravity as well. Starting to connect with the breath. And again, let's go ahead and ring the gong first to start practice. Of your throats, and then exhale in the opposite direction from the tops of your throats down through the ribs, the lungs, all the way to your bellies, as though you're wringing water from a washcloth, bringing navel into spine. Again, perhaps place your right hands on your bellies and your left hands on your hearts. To track the breath as it moves through your bodies. And let's begin. Inhale, two, three, four. Hold, two, three, four. And exhale, two, three, four. Again, inhale, two, three, four. Hold, two, three, four. And exhale, two, three, four. One more time. Inhale, two, three, four. Hold, two, three, four, and exhale, two, three, four. Now allow your breathing to come naturally to its own rhythm. Allow the warmth of your breath to go to any area of your body that is tense or sore. And allow the breath to relieve the tension or soreness that is there. Imagine your breath gathering up all of the tension and soreness in your bodies and breathing it out so that you begin to feel peaceful and relaxed. Any distracting thoughts or feelings that you may have, allow them to be sent out with the breath. And as you breathe, allow yourselves to go deeper and deeper into this state of calm, knowing that you are in control at all times. Connect with a personal intention for this practice. That intention could be physical, mental, or spiritual. And it could be for you or for someone you love. Seal that intention with one deep inhale. And one deep exhale. Good job. Inhale those knees and arms to center. Exhale, knees to the left, arms to the right. Look over that right shoulder and breathe. Again, breathing into this simple twist. Opening up those right obliques as you do. And smile. Again, it's Friday. It's a beautiful day out today. Should get cooler next week. Cooler doesn't mean cool, but it's cooler here. Not over the hundreds, I believe, which is exciting. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, knees to the right, arms to the left. Look over that left shoulder and breathe. Again, breathing into this simple twist. Opening up those left obliques as you do. And smile again. It's Friday. Weekend's coming. It's going to be such a wonderful week again. Next week, inhale back to center. Wrap your arms around your knees. Grab opposite elbows. Rock back and forth. Massage your lower backs and your kidneys as you do. Good job. And then grab onto your insteps. Drag your knees down towards your shoulder blades. Push up with your feet, pull down with your hands, in happy baby. Again, maybe rocking back and forth, touching first one knee and then the other, working towards touching both at the same time if that's in your practice. Again, don't feel like you have to. And again, smile. It's such a beautiful day out today. So much to be grateful for. And then from here, bend your knees, flex your feet, draw your arms up overhead. And since it's Friday, let's go ahead and inhale first. Exhale as you cross over your left thigh, extend your right leg, flex your foot, but don't touch. Inhale back, exhale, cross over that right thigh, extend your left leg, flex your foot, but don't touch. Inhale back, exhale to the left, inhale back, exhale to the right, inhale back, exhale left, inhale back, exhale right. And again, two more or seven more wherever you are. Exhale left, inhale back, exhale right, inhale back, exhale left, inhale back, exhale right. Inhale back, exhale left, inhale back, exhale right, inhale back, exhale left, inhale back, exhale right, inhale back, exhale left, inhale back, exhale right. And again, two more if you're with us. Inhale back, exhale left, inhale back, exhale right, inhale back, exhale left, inhale back, and exhale right. Good job. Inhale back, draw those knees in for a hug, rock back and forth, massage your lower backs and your kidneys, and exhale as you extend your legs down, roll over onto the left side, left elbow, left palm of your hand down, Inhale, your right knee in, grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you. Again, dragging that right shoulder back and down as much as you can in infinity pose, and smile. Maybe grab on to your right calf. Draw it in towards you as much as you can. Inhale, that right knee in. Exhale, down to the end of the mat. Roll over onto your right side. Right elbow, right palm of your hand down. Inhale, your left knee in. Grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you. Again, dragging that left shoulder back and down as much as possible. Maybe grab on to your left calf, dragging your leg towards you. Again, breathing in and out in infinity pose. Inhale, that left knee in. Exhale, down to the end of the mat. Draw your knees in, spinal rolls from shoulder to tailbone and back again. Allowing each vertebra to come back into alignment. We'll do three or four of these. And arrive at the tops of our mats in Sukhasana, simple seated pose, crisscross applesauce. And again, let's go ahead and before we do anything else, inhale that left arm all the way up. Exhale as you come down onto that right elbow, again, reaching towards your third eye on the right side. Feeling that energy coursing from your left thigh to your left fingertips. And again, open up those left obliques. Release toxins as you do. Inhale back to center. Exhale first. Inhale your right arm all the way up. And exhale down to the left. Again, looking up towards your third eye, pointing towards your third eye, feeling that energy from your right thigh through your fingertips, opening up those right obliques as you do, and smile. Again, it's Friday, it's a beautiful day out today. We've never seen this day before. Inhale, back to center. Good job. And then from here, let's go ahead and inhale that right foot up on top of your left thigh. Exhale first. Inhale, both arms all the way up. And exhale as you fold forward, hinge at the hips. Reach, 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 reach. Fingertips come down. Hearts come down. Maybe your third eye comes down. Again, rocking it back and forth, opening up your intuition as you do. Wherever you are is perfect. Inhale as you walk your hands back again. Exhale as you walk your hands to the right, grabbing onto your right knee with your left hand. Bring that right hand back. Or maybe rock forward and take a bind, grabbing onto your right foot with your right hand. Again, opening your hearts to the side wall through the breath. Inhale, back to center. Exhale as you release your foot. Inhale, that left foot up on top of your right thigh. We're in half lotus. Exhale first, shoulders back and down. Inhale, both arms all the way up. Exhale, fold forward, hinge at the hips.
Reach, 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 reach. Fingertips come down, hearts come down, third eye comes down again. Maybe rocking it back and forth, opening up your intuition as you do. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you walk your hands to the left, grabbing onto your left knee with your right hand, bringing that left hand back, or possibly rocking forward and taking a bind again. Shoulders back and down, opening your hearts to the sidewall through the breath. Good job. Inhale back to center. Exhale as you release your foot. We're moving into a headstand. So make sure that you have somewhere on the wall with something comfortable underneath your head. If you're not on the wall, you can use it. You can possibly balance if you'd like to. Interlace your fingers. Place the crowns of your heads in between your hands, but again, maybe tuck in your shirts first. And again, using your elbows as a tripod. Curl your toes under. Inhale as you push your hips up, walking towards your face. And then kick up first one leg and then the other. Again, in a headstand. Again, using your elbows to balance, possibly pulling your heels off of the wall if this is in your practice, but keep your feet flexed and balance on those elbows in the tripod that you formed. Again, breathing in and out. You can also still be on your knees if this is in your practice. Wherever you are, you're in an inversion. Allowing the circulation to go back down to your brain and to your vital organs as you do. You can either bring first one leg down and then the other, or gently bring both legs down at the same time. Wherever you are is perfect. And then come down onto your knees, come up again and towards your mat. Again, on your mat, we're in table. Our shoulders are above our wrists, our hips are above our knees, and if we look between our legs, we shouldn't see our feet. Let's go ahead and walk our knees back, one hand's length. Inhale first. Exhale down to Balasana, child's pose. Maybe placing your third eye on the mat, rocking it back and forth, opening up your intuition. Inhale all the way through, hips come down, shoulders back and down to Cobra. Again, opening your hearts. And then exhale back to Balasana. Good job, child's pose. Again, you can always come to child's pose whenever you like. Inhale all the way through. Again, hips come down, shoulders back and down. And exhale back again to Balasana. Inhale all the way through. Again, once again to Cobra. And exhale back this time to table. Walk those knees forward as you do. Good job. And then from here, let's go ahead and inhale that right arm all the way up. Exhale as you thread it under, coming down onto your right shoulder, excuse me.
Again, square your hips to the front of the room. Inhale that left arm up. Bend your elbow. Find that right hip crease. Again, and breathe. Opening your hearts to the sidewall through the breath. Inhale that left arm up. Exhale down. Inhale your right arm all the way up. And exhale down. Good job. Let's do the other side. Inhale that left arm all the way up. Exhale as you thread it under. Coming down onto your left shoulder again. Squaring your hips to the front of the room. Inhale that right arm up. Bend your elbow, find that left hip crease, and breathe. Again, breathing in to thread the needle, opening your hearts to the sidewall through the breath. Inhale, that right arm up. Exhale, down. Inhale, your left arm all the way up. And exhale, down. Good job. And then from here, curl your toes under, sit back on your heels, again, making infinity symbols with your wrists, opening up your wrists, opening up your ankles and your toes as well. Draw those arms overhead if this is in your practice. In the Uttita, drag your tailbone in, shoulders back and down. And then maybe draw those hands behind you. Fingertips touch, pushing your fingertips up towards the crowns of your heads. Again, in Anjali Mudra, behind your backs. Opening up your shoulders, your wrists, your toes, your fingers, and your ankles all at the same time.
Take these sunken eyes and learn to see all your life.
10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rock forward on your elbows. Slap on your toes. Good job. And then from here, let's go ahead and plant the palms of our hands into the mat. Curl your toes under. Inhale first. Exhale back to down dog. Again, maybe walking the dog, lifting first one heel and then the other, dragging the other heel down towards the mat as you do. Dragging your hearts towards your thighs as much as possible. Again, planting that area between your index finger and thumb into the mat, keeping your wrists safe. Come up on your tippy toes, bend your knees, look towards the front of the mat, drag your tailbones in. Step or jump up, lighter than air, inhale. Halfway up to Ardha Tadasana. Exhale, down to Uttanasana. Again, standing forward fold. Inhale, halfway up. Again to Ardha. Exhale down to Uttanasana. Slightly bend your knees. Inhale all the way up. Swan dive backward. Hands come together. Slight back bend. And hands come to Anjali Mudra. Bowing your heads in honor of your practices. Good job. So from here, we're going to move into Utkatasana since it's Friday. Toes in, knees in. Inhale as you sit back in your chair in Utkatasana. Again, pinky fingers in, drawing that tailbone in, shoulders back and down. Looking up towards your third eye, chair pose. Draw those hands to Anjali Mudra.
twist out to the right. Again, drag your hands to heart center. And then look down. Take a giant step back with your left foot. Again, twisting even more, opening those hearts to the side wall. Open up, north and south. Again, we're in reverse side angle. Take a wrap if this is in your practice. Possibly take a bind, inbound, reverse side angle. Bringing ourselves out. Inhale, up, east and west. Look back to the back of the room, thumbs are up. Spin out. To Virabhadrasana, two. Warrior two. Reach, 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 reach. Palm up. Exalt that warrior. Lift your hearts to the sky. Release toxins. Exhale, back. Straighten your front leg. Place your hands on your hips. Left hip back, right hip forward. Float those hands back up. And then reach, 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 reach. And burst into Trikonasana, triangle pose. Left hip back, right hip forward. Good job. Bend your front knee, coming into side angle. Rotate that left arm around and forward into the Uttita. Again, feeling that energy coursing. Open up once again. Take a wrap. Possibly take a bind, grab wherever you can on that arm, bringing yourselves out. Inbound side angle. Open up. North and south. If you'd like to, look out beyond your mat. Plant that right hand, tip yourselves, and draw that left leg up, flex your foot. Again, we're in Ardha Chandrasana. Maybe grab onto your toes. Again, in a bind. Possibly cup that right hand, drawing it off the mat in a balanced position. Wherever you are is perfect. Good job. Release your foot if you have it. Bend that front knee, tip yourselves back to Virabhadrasana two. If you're on the mat, look down, inhale up to Virabhadrasana two. Cartwheel those arms down. Kick that right leg back. Three-legged dog split. And go through your vinyasa. Or meet us in down dog. Wherever you are is perfect. Again, walking the dog. If this is in your practice, inhale through your noses, side out, inhale. One more time, inhale. Good job. Come up on your tippy toes, bend your knees, look towards the front of the mat. Again, tailbone in, shoulders back and down, and we're in bear pose. Step or jump up, lighter than air. Inhale, halfway up to Ardha Tadasana, making space. Exhale, down to Uttanasana, standing forward fold. Inhale, halfway up to Ardha. Exhale, down to Uttanasana. Slightly bend your knees, inhale all the way up, swan dive backward, hands come together, slight back bend. Hands come to Anjali Mudra. Bowing your heads in honor of your practices. Good job.
then from here, we're moving into Utkatasana once again. Toes together, knees together. Inhale as you sit back in your chair. Again, hands come up. Fingers, pinky fingers are in, shoulders back and down, tailbone in. Draw your hands to Anjali Mudra. Twist out to the left. Again, keep dragging those hands to Anjali Mudra as much as possible. Look down, take a giant step back with that right foot. Again, twisting out as much as you can. Open up, north and south. Take a wrap. Possibly take a bind, inbound, reverse side angle. Open up, east and west. Look back to the back of the room. Thumbs are up. And then spin out to Virabhadrasana 2, Warrior 2. Reach, 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 palm up. Exalt that warrior. Lift your hearts to the sky. Exhale back. Straighten your front leg. Place your hands on your hips. Right hip back, left hip forward. Float your hands up. Reach, 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 and burst into Trikonasana, triangle pose. Good job. Bend your front knee, coming into side angle. Rotate that right arm around and forward into the Uttita. Again, open up north and south. Take a wrap, possibly take a bind. Grab on wherever you can, opening your hearts to the sidewall, bringing yourselves out. Open up once again, and then look out beyond the mat, tip yourselves, and lift your back leg, flexing your foot to the wall in Ardha Chandrasana. Take a bind if this is in your practice. Possibly cup your hand, gently drawing it off the mat in a balanced position. If this is in your practice, release that foot. And again, bend your front knee, tip yourselves back to Virabhadrasana 2. Cartwheel those arms down. Kick that left leg all the way back. Three-legged dog split. And go through your vinyasa. Or meet us in down dog. Wherever you are is perfect. Inhale through your noses, side out, inhale. One more time, inhale. Good job. Come up on your tippy toes, bend your knees, draw your tailbones in, look towards the front of the mat. Shoulders back and down. Again, step or jump up, lighter than air. Inhale, halfway up to Ardha Tadasana. Exhale down to Uttanasana. Inhale, halfway up to Ardha. Take a giant step back with your left foot. Walk that right foot all the way across. Right knee down, left knee down, left top of foot down. Inhale as you walk those hands back. Maybe take Venus Mudra. And exhale as you humbly bow yourselves. Coming down on that left cheek. Again, allowing your wrists to fall towards the center of the room with gravity. Opening up your shoulders. But you can also be on your right cheek, on your elbows, or on your backs. Wherever you are is perfect. Breathing in and out in resting pigeon. Slowly draw those hands back down towards your waist before you release. And again, allowing any unwanted emotion that you may be storing in your right hip to melt into the mat, into the floor, into the earth below where it is recycled, regenerated, into healing energy. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Coming off on your right hip, swing your left leg all the way around. Left foot is parallel to your right thigh. Bring that right foot in and your right elbow in. Inhale that left arm up and around. Find your right hip crease. Possibly take a bind in the Mariandrasana twist again. Shoulders back and down, opening your heart to the side wall through the breath. In the Mariandrasana twist, releasing toxins, massaging our internal organs. And again, remember to drink lots of water after practice. Inhale back to center. Extend your legs and shake them out. Come up to the tops of your mats in Malasana, yogi squat. And from here, again, you can either stay here, shoulders back and down, tailbone in, all four corners of your feet are growing into the mat, or use a bolster under your heels. Lift your toes if you can. The backs of our biceps are just below our knees. You can stay here, as I said, or you can rock forward, planting your hands into the mat or the floor in front of you, finding that sweet spot as you rock back and forth, and then coming into Bakasana, crow pose. Again, we'll be here for 20 seconds, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good job. Building core strength, arm strength. And again, back in Malasana, inhale from your root chakra all the way to your crown chakra. And exhale down again. Inhale. And exhale. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. Place your hands on the mat, inhale halfway up to Ardha. Take a giant step back this time with your right foot. Walk your left foot all the way across. Left knee down, right top of foot down. Inhale as you walk those hands back to Royal Pigeon. Maybe take Venus Mudra and exhale as you humbly bow yourselves. Onto that right cheek this time, if this is in your practice. But you can be on your right cheek, on your left cheek. You can also be on your elbows or on your backs. Wherever you are is perfect. Again, opening up that left hip, releasing any unwanted emotion that you may be storing there, and smile. Slowly draw your hands back towards your waist, release, and then inhale. As you walk those hands back again, coming off on that left hip, swing your right leg all the way around. Right foot is parallel to your left thigh. Bring that right foot in and your left elbow in. Inhale, your right arm up and around. Find your left hip crease. Possibly take a bind in the Marandrasana twist. Again, opening your hearts to the sidewall through the breath. Drag your shoulders back and down as you do. We're massaging our internal organs, releasing toxins as we do. Inhale, back to center. Extend your legs and shake them out. Bend your knees, arms are out on either side of your knees. Inhale first, exhale inch by inch, vertebra by vertebra down to the mat. And when you get there, draw those knees in for a much deserved hug. Rock back and forth, massage your lower backs and your kidneys. And then from here, you can either use your block and move into a supported bridge. Or if you'd like to, since we're Friday, I'll be doing a bridge, or excuse me, not a bridge, a wheel, excuse me, planting my hands into the mat at shoulder height, fingertips are facing my heels, inhale as I push up into wheel, and again, heart opener for the weekend, energizes us, breathing in and out. And slowly bend those elbows, coming down to the mat, placing the crowns of your heads first. Draw those knees in for a hug. If you're in a supported bridge, inhale as you push your hips up, releasing the block. I knew I was going to do that. And then exhale down again. Good job. I always sneeze when I do these kinds of inversions. It's so funny. Not the ones that I do front on the front side, but the ones that I do backwards. It's so funny. And then from here, either leg straight up, flexing your feet. Again, allowing the circulation to come back down to our vital organs and our brain once again. Or possibly push your hips up into a shoulder stand. Walk your shoulders under. And I must say that those three vaccines that I got on, I guess, Tuesday went away right away after the yoga session that I did. I guess it was just yin that we were doing, though. Draw those toes overhead if you'd like to. Again, into halasana or plow pose. Maybe draw your knees around your ears in ear pressure pose or snail pose. And then inch by inch, vertebra by vertebra, coming back down to the mat. Draw those knees in for a hug, rock back and forth. Massage your lower backs and your kidneys, good job. Then exhale, that right leg down. Inhale, your left arm up overhead. Exhale as you push your left knee over to the right. Look over your left shoulder and breathe. Again, breathing into this full body twist. Opening up those left obliques one last time. Inhale, back to center. Draw those knees in for a hug. Rock back and and then exhale that left leg down. Inhale your right arm up overhead. And exhale as you push your right knee over to the left. Look over your right shoulder and breathe. Again, breathing into this full body twist. Inhale, back to center. Draw those knees in for a hug. Inhale through your noses, side out. Inhale. One more time, inhale. Good job. And with that intention, allow your legs to come out as wide as the mat or wider. Arms are down beside your torso. Palms are up to receive, down to ground, starting to relax. Relax your toes, relax your feet, relax your ankles. Relax your calves, relax your knees, relax your thighs. Relax your hips, relax your torsos, relax your fingers. Relax your hands, relax your wrists, relax your forearms. Relax your elbows, relax your upper arms, relax your shoulders. Relax your necks, relax your jaws, relax your cheeks. Relax your foreheads, relax the crowns of your heads, just relax. Start to bring movement to your fingers and your toes by wiggling your toes and maybe touching each finger with your thumb. Reach your arms overhead, extend through your feet, giving yourselves a full body stretch and filling your lungs with your breath. Then exhale as you draw those knees in for one final compassionate hug, rocking back and forth, massaging your lower backs and your kidneys. Slowly roll over to the right side in the fetal position and remain here for a few breaths.
And you whispered to those in pain, now you belong.
Then using the strength of your arms, come back to a seated position facing the front of the room. Legs are crossed, hands are at Anjali Mudra, heads are bowed in honor of your practices. From the place deep in my soul that I know to be pure and true, I bow to and honor that same place that resides within each of you. Thank you so much for coming to practice yoga with me on this beautiful Friday. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and I will see you Monday surrounding Shiri's brother with as much love and healing as possible today and every day. I hope he's able to get back into his home as soon as possible. Again, namaste.
For our nation's golden child. Even though we try,
have a wonderful rest of the day. I am going to go ahead and ring the gong to end practice.
Joy you brought us through the years.
Thank you so much, everyone. I'm going to go ahead and stop the recording.